So the atheistic philosopher, they think that this combination of prakriti and purusha is without any aim, without any idea. Just like a man and woman meets and they may have sex. There was no idea, but they have sex. They give this example. That is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, 16th chapter. There is no aim. And purusha becomes subdued by the prakriti and the manifestation comes. But this Kapila Dev, you will find, and we, Vaishnava philosopher, we do not admit this, that without any aim, there is aim. Why Krishna says that this material world, bhutta bhutta praliyate, bhutta bhutta, there is aim. The manifestation of prakriti, cosmic manifestation, is there to give the living entities another chance for liberation. One chance is given, just like we have got, see, prakriti is now manifested, and we are living entities, we are here. Sarvajonishu kaunteya sambhavanti murtayaya. In many varieties. So what is the aim? The aim is God realization. By evolutionary process, gradually, we come to the human form of life. Asitiṃ chaturāṃ caiva jīva-jāti. Jīva under different species of life, they are evolving. Jalayānava lakkhāni sāvara lakkhavīṃ sati kinvayam rudra-saṅkhaka pakṣināṃ dasa-lakkhakam. In this way, the evolution is coming. From aquatics to plants life, then insect, reptiles, then birds, then beasts, then human life. So this human life, civilized human life, followers of the Vedic principle, that is civilized life, Aryans, Arya. Therefore the followers of Vedic principle, they are called Arya, advanced. Because those who are followers, just like Manusangita, it is Aryan literature, Vedic literature. So Aryan means advanced. Advanced means civilized. So if we civilized people, we give up this Aryan literature or Vedic literature to waste our time, sex literature, then we are committing suicide. The Chaitanya Chaitamrita says, anadi bahirmukh jeev, Krishna bhuli gila. The Krishna is the original father, we have forgotten. Anadi. Anadi means before the creation. Adi means the creation. So, this is a chance. This creation is there to give us chance to come to our original position, Krishna consciousness. So there is aim. It is not without aim. There is aim. And when there is creation, when there is civilized human being, and still they are not taking to Krishna consciousness, then Krishna comes personally to teach them. Yadā-yadāhi dhanma-sakrāni bhavati bhārata tadātmānam sijāmaham. So these civilized nations should take advantage of this Vedic literature. Kadyamuni is teaching Sāṅkha philosophy. Krishna is teaching Bhagavad Gita. And if we do not take advantage of this thing, then again we are in the oblivion. Again this cosmic manifestation will be annihilated and will remain in slumbering state for many millions and millions of years. Again there will be creation. Bhutta bhutta praliyate. This is the mode of creation. So we should take advantage of this Vedic literature. Tad vijnanatham sa guru meiva vigacchet. Everyone should approach the bona fide spiritual master and take lessons from the Vedic literature. Then this life will be successful. We are rotting in this material world. Bhutta bhutta praliyate, getting one short type of body, live there for some time. Again it is annihilated. Again another body. And we do not know what kind of body. That will depend on our karma. So, but you have to accept tatha dehantara prapti. So, this is going on under the influence of kala. So, people should be enlightened that don't remain asleep. Uttishtata jagrata prapta paran nibodhata. Now you are a civilized human being. You can read and write, you can understand. So jagrata. Now get up, be awake. Study this Vedic literature, especially the sense of Vedic literature. Srimada Bhagavatam. Nigama kalpata rur galitam phalamidam. Nigama means Vedic literature, Vedic knowledge. And it is, it's ripe in fruit. Nigama kalpata rur galitam phalam idam. Srimada Bhagavatam. So, here Srimada Bhagavatam, chant Hare Krishna, and be successful in your life. Thank you very much.